Once again, we got another vintage PSA submission for you guys. Let's do it. What's going on, guys? Joe R, Vintage Pokemon, back with another vintage PSA Pokemon card submission. We've got some good ones for you here. We got an Ampharos first edition from Neo Revelations. And a lot of these cards that I'm going to be showing you first, they're probably going to score around an 8. Simply because many of these holographic cards have some sort of factory lines. They're otherwise very, very clean copies. But we've seen from our last couple submissions that clean copies tend to be scoring the 8s these days with PSA because those little factory lines on the front or surface scratches, they're going to knock you down a peg. So hopefully we have some good luck with these. I think a few have definitely a chance of scoring a PSA 9. But that is yet to be seen. We have to wait until they come back. We got a Dark Hypno there. That's a beautiful card. First edition Metal Energy from Neo Genesis. Gorgeous card. Very tough to grade because there's just so much holo pattern. Just very subjective to the factory lines and scratches on the front. Just so much going on there. Another card. Very tough to grade for the same exact reasons. The Ancient Mew card. I think almost everybody that grew up in the 90s has this card, whether it is in a book somewhere or under your bed or something. A lot of people have this. This is a really pretty card. Very, very tough to grade, though. I find it impossible to know what those are going to get. Oh, man. And that is some swirl action on Politoed here. Right there, top left corner. And this is one of the few ones in this initial first submission section that I think has a really, really solid chance of grading a PSA 9. And we've got this big bad boy, Tyranitar. You know, for the longest time, I thought when I was younger that Tyranitar was probably like the best card in this set. And now I understand that it is definitely the Umbreon and the Espeon because they are just, you know, top tier evolutions arts. Not that Tyranitar can be sold short. I mean, he's awesome too. Gotta love the big Godzilla. You know what I'm saying? All right, so that was 8 cards that we have so far. I've got another pile here. These are some that I hand selected. And we're going to be submitting another Error Snorlax. This is a Jungle No Symbol Error card. It's got no Jungle Symbol there, and it's a gorgeous one, too. We got nicked. We got almost all 8s the last time we sent Jungle No Symbol cards in, except Jolteon. We had a PSA 9 come back for the Jolteon, which was just awesome. That was some fire. And I think this card has a pretty solid chance of scoring a PSA 9 also, which is why I wanted to send this one in. So that's a beautiful card that we're going to be submitting. We've got here a first edition, lots of first edition holo cards that we're going to be sending in here. A Sabrina's Alakazam, really solid chance for a lot of these cards to score a PSA 9, I think. Really good centering there also. So we're sending that bad boy in. We've got here our Dark Arbok from the Team Rocket set. He's going in. A Pichu. Love the holo pattern on Pichu here. He's got some factory scratches, though, too. So I'm not expecting him to score a PSA 9. He's also a little off-center. So I'm hoping just to get the PSA 8. That's what I'm expecting for this particular Pokemon card. And we've got ourselves the Giovanni's Nidoking. If you guys like what you see, please don't forget to throw up a like, leave a comment. You know we love having the talks here. And make sure you subscribe because we do nothing but vintage Wizards of the Coast for the most part here. That's what I love to do. I love sharing my collection with you guys, and I love chatting about it at the same time. Giovanni's Machamp. Submitting that off. Hoping for some high-grade action. Beautiful card. Clean back. Good centering. A Dark Machamp. This is the last one I have in my sort of backlog of Dark Team Rocket cards. And really hoping this scores the PSA 9 because we sent 2 off. One came back, I think, a 7. One came back an 8. And I really want the 9 for my collection. So hopefully this one can come back as a PSA 9. We're sending off a non-holographic first edition Dark Charizard, just a little bit of hair there, you know. We don't want that getting into the PSA case, right? So we'll hopefully get that'll come back as a 9 or an 8. Solid card. You wouldn't expect the non-holographics to be worth a lot, but, I mean, first edition still brings in a pretty penny. So we have a Dark Alakazam, first edition holographic. And that's a really nice looking card too. You see the backsides of a lot of these cards. Very, very clean. Hopefully we get high grades for them. Another dark Charizard non-holographic card. This time without a little bit of hair fuzz on there. So that's going to get a good grade hopefully for us. And here's the only Japanese card that I'm actually going to be submitting this time around. This is a gift set promo card. Japanese gift set promo card. Holographic Moltres. And that is a gorgeous art for Moltres. One of my favorites, actually. I mean, a lot of people know and love the Fossil Moltres, but, I mean, this card is awesome. And it is a promotional card. Came with a gift set. As a matter of fact, it's called the gift set promo. It came in the vending series as a non-holographic card. You would peel it. And this was printed for a promotional theme deck. And it came in a really nice looking box and everything. And it's a beautiful card. You can see we got some foot swirl action right there. I'm hoping this will come back as a PSA 9, because that would be pretty sick. Here we've got a Gym Heroes Brox Rhydon. That's a beautiful card as well. We've got ourselves a nice swirl there. Bottom left-hand corner, right under his old hammer arm. We've got ourselves an Erica's Clefable First Edition. Another swirl right there on the left-hand side. We just got lefty swirls all day. And it's a pretty nice-looking card, too. Hoping that a lot of these gym cards are going to score nines for me, because we really could use them for the nine set, if you will. You know, those of you that have been around for a while, I love collecting PSA 9s. I think a mint card is exactly what you'd expect out of a booster pack, and that's what I try to go for. We have Erica's Vileplume First Edition. That's a really nice looking card too. In our last submission, we actually got a Gem Mint 10 Erica Trainer Holo, and that was a really cool pull. Considering that there's so much holo pattern, it's like a silver card, green background, but it's a lot of holo pattern. You wouldn't expect it to get a PSA 10, but it did. And we've got ourselves a Lieutenant Surge's Electabuzz. Probably one of the cheaper, less pricey cards from the Gym Heroes set. So we're going to be sending that off, hoping that it comes back as a PSA 9. Don't have yet a 9 in the collection, so that's why we're sending it off. We have Lieutenant Surge's Magneton, and that's got some nice pop to it as well. First edition card, Lieutenant Surge, and hopefully this one comes back to 9 as well. And we're going to top things off with this PSA submission. We have the Misty's Tentacruel, and that's a beautiful card as well. Hopefully we don't get gunked out on many of these. Hopefully they come back exactly as we would expect. Maybe we'll get lucky and one or two of these can come back a PSA 10. That would be super sick also. So I'm really hoping that we have good submissions here, and wish us the best of luck. All right, and we'll see you guys all next time for the PSA return. Stick around for more great things coming down the pipeline. We've got some cards coming in, cards going out. We sent some cards off to BGS that were PSA 8 grades, and we cracked them out of their case, so hopefully they come back really strong as well. But that's all we've got for you guys this time, and we'll see you all next time through. Bye-bye, everybody.